Hey kids, today we're doing something that is called Lisa's White Chocolate Supremes, and they once again come from one of my murder mystery books by Joanne Fluke from her Blueberry Muffin Murder book. Her recipes intrigue me because they all include melted butter, and I don't know why I find that intriguing. I just do. So what we're going to start with: 1 cup of melted butter, 3/4 cup of white sugar, and 3/4 cup of brown sugar, and we're going to go ahead and we're going to mix that all up nice and good, and then we're going to add in a few more wonderful ingredients. There are a couple of other things that I'm going to have to stop and go on this recipe for. I'm having issues with my computer this morning, so I decided to just do this to kill time. And I won't have time to actually bake them, so we'll be back to do that a little bit later too. So the lighting will change, since this is very early morning right now, and we'll be cooking these later on. Well, brown sugar. Anyway, I think that's weird with the melted butter. It just doesn't kind of blend in. So anyway, we'll be right back. Okay, so that's 1.5 teaspoons of baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and this is going to be 2 teaspoons of vanilla. They say the recipes in the book as well as on the audiobooks, and I realized as I was going through this that the person who transcribed this didn't put in the measurement for the salt, so I had to go back to my audiobook. And thankfully, I had written down the time that it was that she started reading the recipe to us. Okay, that's good. Then we're going to add in 2 beaten eggs. And add that in. And then, last but not least, we're going to add in the flour. And then I'm going to have to get to doing a tiny bit of chopping. This is 2 1/4 cup of unsifted flour. I'm gonna go ahead and mix that all in, and then we're gonna add in 2 cups of real white chocolate chips. It says that you can use regular white chocolate, and you can chop it up in your food processor, or it says you can use vanilla chips, although the taste of this will not be the same. And then I'm also going to measure out 1.5 cups of macadamia nuts, and then I'm going to chop it in my food processor. So they generally end up around the same, you know, when you measure it before and after, but it says definitely to measure the 1.5 cups before. We'll be back. Sorry, I didn't realize I shifted you, and you were kind of off screen there for a second or two. Anyway, the white chocolate, I measured, let's see, it's about 6 ounces of macadamia nuts came out almost absolutely perfectly for the 1.5. So I'm going to go ahead and get that into my food processor, and we'll be mixing that in, and we'll be back. Okay, so I went ahead, got the macadamia nuts, so chopped up. I'm going to mix this in really well, and then later today preheat the oven to 350 and cook them for 10 to 12 minutes. I've always wanted to make white chocolate macadamia nut cookies because they used to be my favorite at Mrs. Fields, or Cookie Corner, whichever one it is. I can't remember one or the other. But anyway, we'll be back later today, people. Okay, kids, we're back about 8.5 hours later. And I have 12. I put them by teaspoonfuls, or rather by these little scooperfuls. They make the perfect size. One thing I did notice: when you melt the butter instead of just softening it and whipping it that way, it just seems like the things don't really, You know, like, you see how the... they're just kind of separate in there. They didn't really stick to one another. So, yeah. Anyway, they're going to go into the 350 degree oven for 10 to 12 minutes. We'll be back. These came out beautifully. So now it says to let them sit for 2 minutes on the tray and then put them onto the rack. Don't let them sit any longer. Oh yeah, it's supposed to be ungreased, an ungreased pan. But you know, when you use your soap hat, you don't have to worry about any of that stuff with sticking and whatnot. So I'm gonna let this rest for a little bit and take them off and we'll see how they are. These are extremely good. Enjoy.